Did you know that every minute of every day, there are human beings living and working in space? It's true. And today, we're gonna show you exactly how they do it. We're gonna take a behind-the-scenes look at all the impressive technology and teamwork that go into making it all happen, so that we can prepare you for our upcoming interview with Leslie Hammond, a woman who works at NASA controlling the robot arms of the International Space Station. As always, be sure to be following along with the flashcards found in your lesson preview. All right, let's blast off for the stars. It's truly astounding to think that humans have ventured beyond Earth's confines and established a continuous presence in space. Humanity's ability to achieve such incredible milestones is a testament to our ingenuity and determination, and it inspires us to reach even further into the cosmos.
We have ignition and liftoff of the Soyuz rocket, beginning the first expedition to the International Space Station, and setting the stage for permanent human presence in space.
You ready for visitors?
We live this dream aboard the International Space Station.
I understand it's good to have you there and adjusting to your new home.
Adapting to life in space, it's been a process.
For the past 20 years, over 230 astronauts from all over the world have worked tirelessly together, boldly performing pioneering research and high-stakes spacewalks in the unforgiving environment of space. In this unparalleled orbital laboratory, circling the planet at 17,500 miles an hour, thousands of groundbreaking scientific experiments from over 100 countries have led to discoveries unachievable in the confines of Earth.
Let's take a look at two of the major spacecraft humanity has used to reach and live in space. And let me tell you, these are some incredible feats of engineering. First up is the Space Shuttle, which was the first ever reusable spacecraft.
11, 10, 9, 8, go for main engine start. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Zero and liftoff of Space Shuttle Atlantis.
NASA used it for space missions for 30 years. The Space Shuttle had a crucial role in transporting the various components of the ISS into space, and the missions were awe-inspiring feats of human ingenuity. The Space Shuttle was designed to hold astronauts and payloads, meaning any objects or materials we decide to send into space. This spacecraft takes off similarly to a rocket, but it lands like an airplane, gliding along a concrete runway when it returns to Earth. Next up, we have the International Space Station. The International Space Station, or ISS, is a research station that is in low Earth orbit. It's a joint project between several different space agencies from around the globe, including NASA, Roscosmos, the Russian space agency, the European Space Agency, and the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency. The space station is approximately the size of a football field and weighs 460 tons. It represents a historic achievement in space exploration. The fact that the ISS demonstrates a scientific collaboration between Russia and the United States, two traditional rivals on the world stage, makes it all the more amazing. At any given time, 6 to 9 astronauts from different countries live there and conduct scientific experiments to learn more about things like how our bodies react to space, how plants grow in zero gravity, and how we can travel farther into space. The ISS is an important platform for international collaboration in space exploration. You know, I've heard of astronauts before, but I've always wondered, who do they call when something goes wrong? Or better yet, who's really in control of all those complicated space technologies up there? Well, that would be a team of experts known as mission control. The Johnson Mission Control Center is located in Houston, Texas, and it serves as the nervous system for the space program. The flight controllers in Mission Control are constantly monitoring the conditions of the spacecraft and communicating with the astronauts on board. A mission just refers to a specific space expedition with a particular set of objectives. A typical mission could be something as simple as replace a solar panel on the space station, but even something like that would require a high level of expertise and coordination from everyone involved. Mission Control is broken into two sections. The front room of Mission Control is where the flight directors and other high-level personnel oversee and manage the mission in real time. Meanwhile, the back rooms are where the specific subject experts and engineers work together to solve complex problems and provide technical support to the flight controllers in the front rooms. Oh, hey, there's Leslie. Don't worry, we're going to hear from her about all these jobs very soon. Each flight controller has a specific role, such as systems, guidance, or communications. Flight controllers are responsible for monitoring and controlling all aspects of a space mission. They work in a series of flight loops, which are rooms that are dedicated to specific areas of responsibility. For example, the guidance flight controller is responsible for monitoring the position and trajectory of the spacecraft. When a space mission goes wrong, establishing communications between the astronauts in space and Mission Control on Earth is critical. Mission Control has many teams of dedicated experts that can quickly assess a situation and determine the best course of action to take. Therefore, the first step is always to establish communication with the astronauts, be it through video or voice channels. This is to both assess the physical and emotional states of the astronauts, as well as to give them necessary guidance and instruction. From there, Mission Control works with the astronauts to troubleshoot the problem, whether it's a malfunctioning system or a medical emergency, and come up with a plan to fix it. In some cases, this may involve sending up additional equipment or supplies to help the astronauts in space, or even conducting a spacewalk to perform repairs outside of the spacecraft. The ultimate goal here is to always ensure the safety and well-being of the astronauts, and Mission Control plays a critical role in making that happen. One of the ways Mission Control aids in space missions is through the use of robotic arms located on the ISS. These arms are needed to complete many different tasks, such as assembling and maintaining the station itself, capturing and releasing other spacecraft, and even conducting experiments. One of the robotic arms is formally known as the Canadarm2 and was built by the Canadian Space Agency. The Canadarm2 is about 17 meters long and has seven joints that can rotate 540 degrees, giving it a high degree of flexibility and range of motion. The arm moves heavy equipment, modules, and payloads around the station, and also assists astronauts on spacewalks. It can also be used to capture and release visiting spacecraft, such as cargo resupply ships or crewed spacecraft. The Canadarm2 is an essential tool for maintaining and upgrading the ISS and has been instrumental in many of the station's scientific achievements. The robotic arms are all controlled by robotic systems engineers on the ground, who can send commands up to the robot arms to make them move. Robotic systems engineers are responsible for designing, building, and maintaining all the robotic systems on the ISS. They work closely with flight controllers in Mission Control to make sure all the arms are functioning properly and can perform their tasks effectively. They also train extensively in simulations that practice emergency situations where they need to control the arm and planning the steps for upcoming missions. When they're controlling the arm in real life, they use a series of sensors and cameras located on the arm and the space station itself to see what's going on in real time. They then send commands in code up to the arm from their computer on the ground that can control every part of the robot. Doing this job takes a lot of training and communication, but we're going to learn more about that in our interview with Leslie from NASA. So, there you have it, a glimpse into the incredible world of space exploration and research, as well as the many talented and dedicated individuals who make it all possible. I hope you learned something today and are inspired to continue to explore the wonders of our universe as we go forward into our interview with our career expert, Leslie, in the next video. Hey.